Hello everybody and welcome to episode 45 on Goldcrest Valley. The lights have just come on. So what I've got here is a fairly big setup. We've got the Manitou, which is gently crashing into our brand new conveyor belt, which is just here. The SL8022 Quantum. This is attached to our case, what is it? Puma 185. Yeah, still not too familiar with the case series. And we've got the New Holland over here with the largest silage pusher or leveller. And the small conveyor attacher for the front of this conveyor belt, so we can hopefully pick it straight off the ground without having to scoop it up with a bucket. But I brought the bucket anyway, just in case. Anyway, what we need to do is get our lights on, and we need to head over to the silage pit, which we created yesterday, or in this case, it was actually last week, just the way you're watching these videos. But yeah, it needs to be all sold, because today we're going to be finishing things off. Now you might be thinking, what, seriously? We actually did finish episode 45? Well, yes we did. Episode 45 is the final episode. However, not strictly true, because there will probably be some more bonus videos in the future. So I'll do like an hour long return every now and then. I can't say it's going to be very frequent, but I'm certainly not going to say that this is the final episode ever on Goldcrest Valley. Because that would be a terrible thing to say. It's a very good map. Right, I'm a bit concerned about crossing over. Too many cars. Now, if we weren't continuing in the future, what I would have done is I'd have sold every machine and sort of, well, liquidated everything to see how much money we actually had. But, yeah, obviously, if we're going to return in the future, if we did return, would have nothing at all, so that wouldn't really work. So despite a lot of you probably being upset with that, I think that is for the best really. Anyway, yes, everybody is still following, which is good to see. We're probably going to have to wait until the morning just because it's still fermenting. It's virtually finished, but it's not quite there. So yeah, we'll just have to wait. But it's better in the daytime anyway, just because it's brighter, you can see more. But I'm sure you can understand the plan now. What I'm going to do is set up the conveyor belt, which I've never done before, so this could be hilarious. And then, using this hollow ass on the front, the silage pusher, I'm going to push all the silage towards the conveyor, and it will hopefully scoop it all up and get it loading. Oh look, the fermenting is done. We'll still wait until it's a bit lighter though, just because it's easier to see. Anyway, here we are. Wait to see what the car's doing. Just don't want it to crash into us, really. It would mess things up. Right, so yeah, like I say, I've never done this before. Never set up the conveyor belts. This could be terrible. Could go really badly wrong. But we will have to see. Oops. Right. Okay. Let me just turn the follow me off. There we go. That should improve things, and the one behind as well. Stop, fool! Stop! Stop! That's weird. Can't seem to stop it anymore. That's always worked in the past, but for some reason not today. Right, okay, so now we've got a bit more space. We will leave the lights on the Manitou just to illuminate the area. This, I believe, is the first conveyor which is going to be used. But before we do put it close to the position it's going to stay in, I might just detach it because I believe you can actually drive the thing. The tractor was just to get it here. Otherwise it'd be about 2 or 3 miles per hour. Yes, here we go. We're actually driving a conveyor belt. I couldn't really imagine going to the shops in one of these. That would be a bit weird. It's alright, I'm just going to the shops in my conveyor. Right, okay, so we'll start the engine, if it has one. Yes, I think it is just for ease of use. And we want to angle it over here quite a bit. So let's just get it in line. Because the conveyor belt itself does actually extend. We'll pan it up. and of course extend it as far as we can do, then we know exactly how far back we can go. It's pretty huge. That is massive. Right, so it's daytime. It's much easier to see stuff. I think we're not going to be able to reach completely into the pit here, but we'll be able to get close enough. How's that? Is that all right? Hopefully. I think that's over. Should be. And yes, we'll just put the wheels in. Should prevent it from moving. If that's what it's for, I don't know. Yes, let's just reverse back. And I'm pretty sure that this is the conveyor belt for this one here. So it's like an extension for it. But again, we want to be fairly aligned, otherwise it's not going to work. And with this great big thing on the front, it's going to be quite difficult. Right, okay, that's okay. If we can attach it from there. Ooh, it's a bit close. Scrapage. Lots of scrapage. Can you drive this one behind? You might be able to. Yes, you can. Well, in that case, we'll take it off the New Holland. That's going to make it much easier. Ah, but it only goes forwards and backwards, it would appear. So maybe that's still quite difficult. We'll control it from the other one. Just here. If we go forwards, try to attach to it. There we go. That's got it. And then go back again. Hopefully, that is going to be an improvement. Ugh. It's a very tricky thing to drive. Very tricky. Right, so do we have any different settings for it? Don't think we do. Yes, you can probably tell I've never done this before, ever. But I'm hoping that that is going to be okay. We'll leave it there. That should do it. Is that set up properly? I really don't know. But let's open the silo. There we go. And we will begin. If this hasn't worked as it should have done, I'll do a bit more research in a second. But I was just being a bit confident here, just hoping that I'd get it right. We will find out in a second. Right, okay, then let's push this down here. Aha, that is working. Yes, it's going up the conveyor. And it should start to sell. It is selling. Fantastic. Why can't I remove the rest of the cover? I'm guessing it removes itself, but it doesn't seem to be. Let me just lift this up. Right, so I've discovered the issue. It's a bit strange, really. You have to push it with a bucket first in some cases, otherwise it doesn't fully open. And if you go straight in with the leveler, it can actually delete it instead of selling it, which is a bit weird. So this is folding back the covers. Technically, which moved the tractor around the way. Yeah, I wouldn't have known this. I thought it would have just unfolded naturally, but no, you have to do it with the bucket, it would appear. Unless it's just me. Maybe it's just a temporary glitch for me, but it doesn't really matter. Hopefully that'll fold back. We are full out, so we might have to come back for that. Dump it here, and we will fully unfold this, and then we can use the leveler again. That is the plan. Yes, there we go. Last bit, fantastic. Right, the leveler is much easier than the bucket, although the bucket does work. Okay, let's move out of the way. and jump back into the New Holland tractor. It's a bit of income. Shame we did lose some. I'm surprised it deleted it, that's a bit weird. But it did, I was watching it. The fill level was decreasing as I went over it with this, and it wasn't being sold. Yeah, some people put it on the front and some people put it on the back. To be honest, actually, it probably is easier on the back. Push this forwards into the conveyor. And this is quite a big pusher as well. There are two sizes, this is the biggest of the two. If we can push them from the back here, that'd be easier. We do have larger tractors, so we could put a bigger tractor on the job. This tractor is struggling a little bit. That's a big load. Look at it go. Oh no, stopped in its tracks. Yes, I think we'll swap the tractor over. And I don't know what to do really, whether or not to put it on the back. That looks crazy. The thing was flying into the air. Yeah, we'll just put this over here. We'll get the case tractor, which is obviously huge compared to this little New Holland. And yes, I think it should not bounce quite as much. It does seem a little bit too big for it. Okay, so we'll drive in here. We can actually fold this up and use it that way, which might again be an easier option. Right, okay, so this could be quite interesting. See how it performs with this great big load. Get some momentum behind us. Oh, look at that. Easy. Getting harder. Push the rest of it. Yeah, suddenly it's like a wall it hits. Great big wall. Stops it in its tracks. Must be quite heavy though, I suppose, if it's pushing a great big pile. Yeah, it's got stuck again. There we go. Yeah, it's quite a mound. Still some up here. Once it's all clean, we'll pack up and just see if there's anything else to do in the main yard. You can actually get bunker cleaners. And that would totally clean the bottom of it. So next time we bring in some chaff, it won't get confused and say, oh no, wait, there's already fermented silage in here. So that should all work perfectly. There was an issue when the game was first released, but I think that is now fixed. Anyway, yes, except for this bit up here, the job is finished. we go. We'll add it to the collection. Fantastic. Bunker silo is empty. Yeah, like I say, it's a shame that we had that bit of a glitch at the beginning. I think I probably did something wrong. But in the end, we did okay. We got a bit of money, probably half what we should have done. I can add it in later if we need to. If we know what the price was. What was the price, just for reference? Let's just have a look. It could have changed because I've already sold some. But the current price, have I already gone past it? The current price is £342 per 1,000 litres. So, not really that much anyway. Anyway, what we'll do is put this here. And we will fold up the conveyor. Ideally, actually, we do need to remove the other one. And yeah, it should retract. Now, where should we put it? I just thought, you know, we must have quite a bit of silage over at the cow farm. I don't know if it's fermented. If it is, we could sell it, but if it isn't, it's obviously not worth doing anything with. Not yet, anyway. It's not a good sign. Oh, wait, it is. And I'm guessing it's ready to sell. It is. Open silo. Hmm. Well, it's tempting. We could sell this as well. I think we probably should do. But obviously we need to go up it with a bucket first. So we totally open this up. And this is actually 121,000 litres. So there is plenty of it. Hmm. I'm regretting folding up the conveyor. This is my chance to redeem myself and do it properly. The first go was a practice. Let's go for it again. The difference is, though, we're not going to be taking it out of a pit. We're actually going to be tipping the trailer directly into the front of the conveyor. So it doesn't actually matter where the front of the conveyor is. It doesn't even need to be that extended. In fact, we don't even need to extend it at all. As long as it's got the front on, it'll be fine. So I'll just turn it around here, put the front onto this conveyor. That will allow it to pick it off the ground. And yeah, just as long as we can get the tractor in and out, we'll be fine. So, about here. That should work okay. That's the plan. So all we have to do is obviously get a Manitou, which we have, and a trailer, load it up at the other end, and then tip it here. That is the only way I can think of doing it. Obviously, we could get another conveyor, but that is a bit of an unnecessary expense. I suppose we could rent it. We'll see how we go. If it is a bit too slow, then yeah, we'll go for another conveyor. But we don't want to be spending too much money. So the best thing to do is to go back to the main yard, pick up the Joskin trailer, probably with the fence, and begin the process. I think the Fendt is powerful enough. It's quite a chunky tractor. What is it, 720? Well, 720 is 200 horsepower, so that is fine. And again, I think Follow Me is going to be very useful here. Oh, look at the header. How did that happen? Anyway, that's a job for another day. Let's just get the Manitou following this tractor. And then the fairly slow process of loading it up is going to begin. I think it is going to take quite a long time. I'm not quite sure what the capacity of the bucket is on the Manitou, but I'd guess it's about 3,000 litres. If that. It can't be too big. And we've got 120, was it 121,000 to do? Yes, this could take some time. and we're losing light because I stupidly forgot to slow down time. So, if it does get too dark, which it shouldn't do, we'll skip to the morning. But I think, yeah, we should have another, certainly another half an hour in real time. And here we are. We'll put the tractor in a good position, so we don't have to drive too far each time. Better stop the Manitou, otherwise it's going to come and crash into us. So I think probably about there. And yeah, let's just, first of all, start scooping. And hopefully it will start to uncover the clamp. It should take the sheet off. Yeah, I now understand what I did wrong before. I did it fairly catastrophically wrong. Okay, that's not too bad. Looks like the capacity is 4,500. That's quite good. One thing I wouldn't want to be doing this with is the bucket for the tractor. Or better yet, a hand shovel. Because that would be very painful and incredibly boring. So yeah, it's not going to be too many scoops to fill the trailer. I don't know the exact capacity of this trailer, but I should think it's going to be in the region of 10 scoops of this loader, I would have thought. Obviously, providing it's a full load as well, which this one isn't. I have just noticed there is a spider running across my monitor. 1 second while I deal with it. Right, okay. So the spider is dealt with. This is, I think, 80% full. I have spilt a bit. Seems to be the back main load which needs a bit more, so final load, if there is a final load, we'll put in the back. I doubt it'd be a full bucket load, but either way, we'll see how much we can get in. And there we go, we're full. All we have to do now is go and take it over to the conveyor. Better turn the engine off. Hopefully, it will work out smoothly. I've got stuck on a mound of some silage. Oh good. Floor it. Oh no, now I'm grounded on some silage. I must have spilt quite a bit. Oh, where are you, Difflock? We need you. I can't believe this. We better get that cleaned up before we head back again. Wow. What a performance. Yes, we don't want to be spilling too much. Oh, now I've got the Manitou stuck on it. What is it? Like a rock in it or something. There we go. Fuss about nothing. Right. Over to the BGA. And this potentially is quite a bit of money in here. Can we cover it over? Don't think we can do. But it doesn't really matter. Right. This feels pretty heavy. And here we are, making our grand arrival out of the conveyor belt. Yet it should be just a case of reversing up to them and then tipping, and hopefully it will sell. One thing I'm a bit concerned about is tipping too fast, because otherwise it will spill over and it will go out of the reach of the conveyor. So need to be a little bit careful here. But we'll hope for the best. Right, is that working? Yep, that's working. Obviously we can do it faster than that, it's just a test. Oh, it's making it go all berserk. We'll wait for it to just dispose of the bit which is there, and then I'll fold it up. Because that, I don't know the exact reason, I don't know if it's so it can turn on the spot or if it stops it from moving forwards and backwards. It probably is a bit of both. But yeah, this is balancing. I'm probably not doing it exactly right, but as long as I'm vaguely right, that would be okay. Yes, I did say okay. Some people have heard other variances of that pronunciation. Yeah, that's not really worked. How is he turning quite so much? That is weird. There. Stop moving, silly thing. Tip the rest. Oh. It's because it's... Maybe if I move forwards more. We'll just tip it and then come back and see if it's sorted itself out. We'll leave it to it. Although, the conveyor is moving around again. Yep. Weird. It needs a handbrake. It seriously needs a handbrake. Well, we'll leave it to it. And here we are, ready for load number two. This time I'll try not to spill. We'll put some in at the back first, and then we'll obviously put some in at the front and then level it off. And it's going to need cleaning eventually. Now, sort of decided that we should probably leave some in here, as it is going to be feed for the cows as well. So we don't want to get rid of all of it. We'll see how much we've got left after this load. If there's not really too much, we'll leave it. If there's still plenty, we'll sell some more. But I have a suspicion the capacity of this trailer is approximately 45,000 litres, possibly more. I will just check. If it is, then we'll pretty much sell it all. Oh, it's 31. Okay. Not good. So that would mean it would be 62,000 we would sell with two loads, meaning there would still be a lot left. So, yes, there will certainly be another load to sell after this one. I'll keep trying to get full loads, otherwise it is going to take literally forever. And I'm going to continue off screen. I will see you in 1 second. And I think we have pretty much finished. This might be the last load. Yes, it is. As you can see, I did overflow it. That was a spill. I was going to say I didn't spill it, but I did just then. The other one was an overflow. Right, so I'm going to put this here. And we're left with, currently, 55,000 litres. So, yes, one more load, and that would be perfect. Hopefully the conveyor belts could sort themselves out. We might get back there and they'll be on their side, on fire. We'll have to see. So I know we are doing the same job for the entire episode, but there isn't really a great deal for us to do. Now, there will be some more jobs which will be suggested over the next few months from different viewers, and I'm going to add them to a list, and then eventually we'll be able to do them in a future episode. But yeah, for today, oh look at this, what a mess. Oh dear. We'll tip it, and then we'll sort it out by driving this. There we go. So if we stay in here, we can control it, and hopefully, it'll be able to process it all without stopping. It is slowly filling up. But although it doesn't look pretty, this is working very well. There is a lot of silage just there. One thing's for sure though, this is definitely faster than tipping it in a pile and then having to scoop it all up again with the Manitou and then tipping it in here with the bucket. This is way faster. Although the money we're getting is next to nothing. Not incredibly impressive. If we sold some more in say 24 hours, we would get a better price. The more you sell together, the worse the price is. Right, that's dying off a bit. If it stops, I'll reposition. There we go. Right. Best thing to do then is drive forwards. That should do. We'll get the next load ready. And hopefully this time we'll be able to finish off without needing our help. Is it spilling? Still seems to be selling, but I think it's okay. I think it is, hopefully. Right, quickly, final load. Here we come with the final load of silage, another 30,000 or so litres. This should, well, it's actually not going to go very far at all. The price of it is horrific, but it's all extra money. We might finish off with £58,000, possibly. That might be a bit too optimistic, but we'll see. I should think there is still some to sell off the ground. I doubt it will have picked it all up. We're going to have to sort it out. But yeah, let's just head over there. And we'll get the conveyor going again. And hopefully, everything will be sold by the end of this video. Yes, there is a great big pile there. Maybe it's easier without the extension. I'm not too sure. I don't even know if it works without the extension. May do? May not do. We'll have to see. But yeah, let's just tip this thing up. There we go. Lovely great big pile of silage. A lot of it. Is there any way of taking off the drawbar? Because that seems to be the issue. Couldn't find a way of doing it. Anyway, we'll start this thing up. We will rotate the wheels and hopefully turn it around a bit. There we go. And continue selling. But that is quite an impressive pile. We certainly did have a lot of silage to sell, which is incredible because it didn't really seem to take too long to make. Hang on, it has rotated. It only seems to move when I'm not in it. That's really weird. Like if I sit in it now, I bet it doesn't move at all. But it is being consumed. It's going up the conveyor belt, slowly disappearing. But there's plenty of it. If we do have to reverse back, then we will do. I said 58,000. It looks like we're going to do it quite easily. Yep. There we go. 58,000. Maybe 60,000. We'll have to see. Well, I think one thing's for sure, there is way more in this pile than it first looked. There is a lot here. It just keeps going. The pile is incredibly slowly going down. The money is also incredibly slowly going up, but it's lasting a very long time. And it's taking it from nowhere. Very good range. A little bit there is going to disappear. Very slowly again. Everything is very slow. But still, we seem to be making quite an impressive amount of money. So it's just stopped. It can't reach any further. We're going to have to realign, which is proving to be quite difficult. And here we go, the final little bit. There we go. There it goes, the end of it. The very last little bit of silage. And we're done. So thank you very much for watching, everyone. Hopefully you've enjoyed this series. Like I say, we will be returning at some point. I can't say when, but at some point we'll definitely do another episode. But until then, thank you for watching everything. I really do appreciate it. And until next time, see you again soon. Bye for now.